Anyway, let's talk about climate change, the coronavirus, and carbon emissions. Okay, so this is apparently, look, you open up any news article and coronavirus is literally every single thing.
Yeah.
I go to every website, Google, Fox News. This has taken over.
Yeah.
It's scary.
Literally and figuratively. Right.
And so when I did a search for climate change, I'm like, I wonder what's going on climate change. What comes up? Coronavirus. So carbon emissions are down by about 25%. There's been a huge dip in production or in use of carbon emissions, 25% lower than during the same period last year. So actually, it's not even that it's down by 25% because you'd expect some growth.
Right.
So it should be up a little bit.
A little bit. Yeah.
So it's actually down. So it's even worse. Right.
Or better.
No, it's like,
I know.
Right. Right. I see. Or better. No, the funny thing is, how must it feel to be like a hardcore climate activist to know that everything you've said and done has been pointless? And
all it took is a crazy virus to escape.
Well, no. The reason you should feel bad is because you've been wasting your time yelling when you should have been manufacturing the virus. No, I'm kidding, by the way. But it reminds me of Kingsman. You ever see?
I think I saw it once. It was about someone trying to release a virus, I guess.
No. The bad guy is Sam Jackson. And he basically says, when the world is overpopulated, it gets the fever. And the fever heats up and it kills the people. And that's how he talks, right? So the idea is that global warming is a fever to kill humans to help save the planet from the virus, right?
Global warming is the fever.
Right.
Oh, okay.
And so he decides that he's going to release these phones that vibrate and make you lose all your inhibitions and become really angry so everyone kills each other. They start fighting. That's basically what the movie's about.
Plan?
Yeah, but anyway, this is not that, right? Obviously not. The coronavirus isn't turning people into zombies or anything.
Yet.
But the point is, you want to stop climate change, there you go.
That's
25%.
That's so much, though. Like, 25% lower is huge. And it's just China's carbon emissions. Okay.
Yeah.
Wow. Over the past 3 weeks, that's nuts.
So here's what they say. The coronavirus outbreak in China, which has sickened at least 77,000 people, it's higher now, shut down factories, refineries, and flights across the country. As officials order people to stay home, as a result, China's carbon dioxide emissions over the past 3 weeks have been about 25% lower than during the same period last year, according to calculations by Lori Milivitverta. Sorry, crazy, hard for me to pronounce last names. An analyst at the Center for Research on Energy and Clean Air. China is such a huge industrial polluter that even a temporary dip like this is significant. The three-week decline is roughly equal to the amount of carbon dioxide that the state of New York puts out in a full year.
Wow.
About 150 million metric tons, Ms. Milivitverta estimated. The number is offering a sobering reminder of how deeply the modern economy still depends on fossil fuels, whether industrial activity declines, whether because of recession or a major disease outbreak, climate pollution tends to plummet too. You can see the drop in China's coal consumption in the chart above. Every year, the nation's coal use falls during the week-long holiday around the Lunar New Year, which occurred on January 25th this year. Coal-burning emissions then typically rise again once people return to work and factories spring back to life. But this year, coal use has yet to rebound. In late January, the Chinese authorities extended the New Year's holiday and restricted travel and public gatherings in an attempt to stop the coronavirus from spreading. You know why this is, look, there's a light, what's the saying? When God closes the door, he opens a window.
Right.
One of the biggest problems with people like, Greta Thunberg, and she's just kind of a mascot.
Yeah.
But all these people, why do they ignore China?
Yeah, that's true. She's like yelling at the people that are actually
fighting.
They're actually trying to like make moves. There's obviously people in their way, everyone agrees, but China is definitely at 25%. It's that much? That's crazy.
But this is a
New
sign,
York in
right?
1 year?
This story is really, really good news because it's kind of a wake-up call to a lot of people. They'll probably ignore
hopefully,
it.
Hopefully. You'd think so.
But I imagine it this way.
I don't know.
Like, Greta Thunberg, look, I'm sorry, but she is the highest profile. She's being nominated for these, peace awards or whatever, Nobel or whatever. And I'm imagining, imagine there's a person at the park who showed up to, have a barbecue. And while their food is cooking, they're burning stuff. They go around and pick up some trash. And she's standing there scowling, yelling at you, "How dare you? Don't eat that food." And right behind her is a guy chucking cigarette butts, not caring.
Yeah.
That's what it feels like.
Yeah.
We here in America, have done a really, really great job of fighting this kind of stuff,
yeah,
taking it seriously, and China don't care. They're building more plants. They're using more. Mm-hmm. And so what we get from this coronavirus thing, I know it's really, really bad and it's going to hurt us too, but we do get to see kind of a smack in the face to these people like, hey, while you've not been paying attention to what they've been doing, they've been pumping out like crazy. And thanks to the fact they've had to do a dramatic reduction because of the coronavirus, it's now the big, big story in the New York Times, or one of the big stories.
Yeah.
You can't ignore it. I mean, you can. They probably will, you know. But I don't, yeah.
So part of the reason maybe that Greta goes to the U.S. and some of these Western countries is because we are more likely to make these changes. And I kind of understand that. But at the same time, we're not the biggest polluters.
No, it's because, like, we'll give them money.
Yeah, exactly. We, like, are more, we're more likely to do stuff.
Well, there is one thing, though. We are outsourcing everything to China.
Yeah.
So all those factories are for us.
Yeah.
That's it's all we're buying all the stuff.
So she could shut it down by going to them, and it would look. Here's what I
realized. Or we can stop buying all our stuff from China.
If I was selling hopes and dreams with no guarantees, mm-hmm. am I going to go to the people who don't care, the people who are already trying? That's what it is. See, that analogy of being in a park,
mm-hmm.
picking up trash, Greta's sitting there trying to sell you a pooper scooper. Like a claw to grab trash.
Yeah.
So of course she's not going to go to the guy who's flicking cigarette butts. He clearly doesn't care. He doesn't want to buy what she's selling.
Right, exactly. That's what I'm saying. We kind of care already, so she's going to try to peddle this to us.
Yep.
Kind of makes sense.
And we buy it.
Yeah, we do.
And the people here are dumb.
Pushovers.
And
except I know people in Sweden, and I know that she's just a face to the people that are, like, writing her speeches for her.
Well, that was exposed already.
Yeah.
Like, so
it's like,
there was a glitch.
How is she winning stuff? You said because she's getting, like, a peace prize?
Yeah, didn't they nominate her for some prize?
They nominated her. I don't know if she won. She's nominated for something else now. I don't
There was a glitch on Facebook, and it revealed who writes her posts. Mm-hmm. And it was her dad and some other Indian guy,
wasn't,
I think.
Her.
Yeah. Hmm. And then she commented, like, oh, you know, it's just, like, you know, I just use Twitter and then repost stuff here. And this is the guy who made the page. Ignore the man behind the curtain.
Mm-hmm.
Said nothing to see here.
Us.
Right. Right, exactly. No, that's what it was. You see this you know, child, and they're like, she's a child, don't attack her. It's like, dude, a child isn't writing her speeches and telling her what to say.
That's why she's a child.
Yeah.
That's why they chose a child. So
you know, did you hear about this, the new activist, the anti-climate?
Oh, the anti-Greta.
Yeah, like
that
either.
In Germany. She's going out. She's like a 14-year-old.
She's 19.
No, she's 19.
Oh, she's 19? Oh, okay.
Let me just interject here and say, stop outsourcing your opinions to children.
Yeah, please.
Yeah.
Grow up. I don't care if you're conservative, progressive, liberal, leftist, right wing, whatever.
Cut it out.
Dude, it's so.
Be bold. Be confident.
Obviously, anti-Greta is
human.
Because of Greta. Right?
Yeah.
But obviously. Dude, look at.
Because honestly, I just think it's like a publicity stunt.
Absolutely.
For everybody.
That's all it is.
But I can understand the anti-Greta. Mm-hmm. Because you have Greta getting all this attention, and they're going like, oh, what a child. And they're using establishment and legacy media.
Yeah.
And they won't listen to anybody who criticizes her.
Right.
So you bring out another inversion of her, and then it's like, okay, ignore your own standard. And of course they do, because they have no standards.
They should know that. They're not going to pay any attention to her.
Yeah, they're not.
So what happens then? What if, you know, should we be rooting? Should Greta be rooting for the destruction of China and the expansion of the coronavirus?
Yes.
Well, if
consistent. You imagine? It furthers her cause.
Right.
I mean, if it gets worse and drops to 50%, suddenly the skies are clear.
No, think about it.
In China.
She says we don't want to wait to 2050, to 2030, or even 2021. We want all fossil fuels stopped now.
Oh my gosh. What if she's the cause?
Oh my
she
gosh. Made
it. No. Hold
did
on.
It.
Here's
she
the point.
She turns into a bat.
Here's
and
the,
flies over there
and bites some guy. No. But listen. Here's the question. If she really thinks we should stop all right now, here's the question. Would you then think it's better if more Chinese people get sick and die, if it stops the fossil fuel burning? Or do you think they should recover and increase fossil fuel consumption by 25% or more? Which one's the right thing? What's pick one.
This is an interesting question.
No, thanks.
Yeah.
No, I'm saying she would have to.
Yeah, this is a good question for her to tackle.
Right.
Like, someone should ask her that.
Should more people get sick?
If anyone has a chance, ask Greta this question.
Is this worth human life?
Well, because what she's talked about, cutting off all fossil fuels, would result in millions dead.
China does, clearly they have the most fossil fuel emissions on the planet. You know, they have all the factories.
Yeah, it used to be us, but we've done a good job.
Well, we gave them all our factories.
Mm-hmm. That's true.
They produce everything the for buck. Us. Yep. So, you know, once it comes back the other way, it might not be that same thing. But, you know, yeah, they need to cut it out. But it's not if it means everyone dying. That's what
but, I think. So the issue is that Greta has said we won't wait till 2050, 30, or 2021.
Right.
End it all now.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So what happens to the people in northern Sweden who rely on, like, the trains to bring in food because, mm-hmm. you know, they can't grow it in the winter?
Or stay warm in the wintertime.
Yeah, no heat, no fuel, no food for you.
Yeah,
cut them off. Like that's what's crazy to me is that there are people who are so ignorant, they don't understand what's happening in China is the perfect example of what you get. You can have your carbon, you know, emissions drop dramatically within less than a year.
Oh yeah,
when a ton of people get sick and die.
Well, there's companies out there that are making alternative coal that's not coal, and it doesn't burn the same. I think it's made from wood. Or something. I'm not sure exactly.
I mean, it's all carbon.
It's all, yeah, it's all going to kick out the exhaust anyway, but it's not as bad.
Can we just replace all carbon emissions with, like, plasma arcs, like we have those lighters? Why burn fossil fuels when we can make plasma to burn things?
Yeah, we need Elon to, like, finish his project with going to Mars and then go, you know what? I need an energy source that's, he needs to become Tony Stark and make the arc reactor, basically.
Well,
that's what we need.
I think...
If you can, Elon, work on an infinite battery.
Basically,
I know you think about it.
Every single form of energy production is literally just spinning a magnet. Did you know that?
Wasn't there like an electric magnet generator that doesn't need fuel? It's just a battery that spins because of magnetic energy?
No.
No.
No, no.
But why wouldn't that be a thing?
Conservation of energy.
But
entropy?
Yeah, I guess so.
Second law of thermodynamics.
Yeah, so eventually you'd have to replace pieces. Okay.
Well, so you can't, like, a battery is not going to produce, like, using a battery to spin a motor.
No. I'm not talking about a battery. I'm talking about, here's one magnet with positive. Here's a negative magnet.
Because the poles are equal.
Well, or okay, so two positives then. Sorry.
No.
And this positive is static. This positive's on a wheel. So when it reaches here, it pushes.
No, it doesn't. It pulls.
Two positives?
So if you have a positive here and a positive here, it won't go around. It'll stop because it's being pushed. It's being repelled.
In both directions. It couldn't continue.
So you have all these people who try and make these videos about perpetual motion machines, and they're all fake.
I thought that was a case. I thought that was maybe it was just something I read that wasn't
true. Nope, there's just people who claim they've done it, and they've never done it because it violates the second law of thermodynamics. So, you know, there's some really interesting things that seemingly would violate some of these laws, like there's an internal photon drive or electron drive, I think it is.
Mm-hmm.
And the way it works is you have this closed, like, metal box.
Oh, the M drive.
Is that what it is? It fires particles.
Yeah, yeah.
And then actually ends up, like, in a weird way.
Well, what about the Tulare current? Like, that's what Tesla was using in his experiment. And it was basically just using the natural current where the sun pushes around. It's called the Tulare current.
And I don't know anything about that. What I do know is that even, like, what we call renewable energy, it's just solar energy.
Yeah,
like,
the sun is the reason we have energy.
We're just trying to harness the energy from the sun in various ways.
Just build a Dyson sphere. Let's just get it over with. Have you seen the movie Sun?
No. Is that what
it's Cillian Murphy? He's, like, on a ship with, it's not a full Dyson sphere. It's been a long time, but it's, like, basically it's a ship that they sent right to the sun to soak up more energy. And just sits hovering around the sun collecting energy to send it back to Earth.
We'd have to build stuff so massive.
I know, it's true.
It's crazy because we need more people to do it.
Well, if we had a base on the moon.
Artemis Project.
Which is happening now.
That's happening next year.
I'm rather excited about it.
Yeah,
I would like to go to the moon one day and visit. I saw Ad Astra on the flight.
Did
you like, movie.
I thought it was good. It was not like super action packed.
No,
it's a little bit.
But you know what? He's a good actor.
I thought it was fun.
He carried that movie so well because he you know, wore the emotions really well, and you saw what he was going through. It was cool. Good
That's
movie.
Cool.
Check it out if you haven't seen it.
So I guess we can kind of wrap this one up just because I'm thinking, like, what I find most interesting about this is you are faced with the paradox of today's energy demands and needs.
Yeah, exactly.
Sickness, disease, pandemic, and you get your desire with those carbon emissions being dropped.
Yeah, it's like these factories going out. It's like what I was talking about earlier, like that whole cog of the wheel
being
is taken
out.
But all the wheels could fall down and kill so many people, you know?
Right.
It's like it's not so easy at just going, no more fossil fuels.
Here's the last question I have for all the climate activists. If we could cure everyone of the coronavirus right now, and it meant that the carbon emissions in China would go up by 25%, would you do it? I would.
I don't know if they would.
I think I would.
I would save the lives.
I think I would save the lives too, yeah.
That's the challenge. We're not going to become these people that think we can sacrifice the lives of people, because then who becomes the death dealer who decides who gets to live and who doesn't?
Who decides? Right.
You know, and I'm sure there's a lot of people out there that are just going, yeah, let them die. Let them die. Because they think, you know, it's like Batman and the Joker at the end, where he's got the two boats and he's like, yep, they're going to kill each other. Yep. And that guy's like, well, if you can't do it, I'll do it. And he picks it up and he's like, and throws it back like you can't do it. Yeah, yep. Because no one's in that position.
Or the convict
who goes, it's easy to go, you should just press the button. But to get up and actually press the button, to actually make the decision, it's much
different. But the best part is when the convict guy goes, if you can't do it, give it to me. And he takes it and chucks it out the window. Oh, that was awesome. Yeah, I love that movie.
That was a good scene.
All right, man, we'll wrap this one up. Thanks for checking out this segment from the Timcast IRL podcast. We do the show every Monday through Friday at 8 p.m., sometimes an hour or two. And we do have a full live recorded version of the show that includes a lot of comments and smaller segments you probably don't see. If you want to check that out, you can watch live at 8 p.m. Monday through Friday, or become a member of this channel. And for $5 a month, you get full access to all of the recorded podcasts. Every day after the show, we make them available in the community section of this YouTube channel. So don't forget to subscribe and stick around for more segments and more shows Monday through Friday at 8 p.m. Thanks for hanging out, and we will see you all in the next show.